Sports. Chiefs for the extra point. Extra point is good. Fields the football at the three. And he'll... all by himself in the backfield for this snap. The Giants take it from the 33. Odell Beckham. The ball. Coming to the line at the 45. First down at the 45. Bailey's there to take him down. One player to watch on that offense today, the electrifying wideout, Odell Beckham Jr.
It's amazing the fame and everything that came his way, and rightly so. Just from the games he played last year, he was a force and one of the best talents I've seen come to the NFL in a long time.
This is third down. And Jennings lined up now as the running back behind the quarterback. It's into the surefire hands of Odell Beckham Jr.
The line of scrimmage is the 26-yard line.
First down here after the completion. Intercepted!
Midway through the first quarter, and it's always a time where you're punching and counterpunching. And now they've got the pick and a chance to even score again.
Now, what would you know about punching and counterpunching, Jim? Were you a boxer at one time? It's amazing. You've done every sport. But you're right. They went out there. They did everything right. They've done everything right on both sides of the ball, and they're looking good.
Alex Smith's going to take it from the shotgun. Pass is made, but the hit knocks the ball out. incomplete.
One player to watch today on the outside is Jeremy Maclin.
Well, Jeremy Maclin had so much success with the Philadelphia Eagles and a good route runner. Let's see if he can be as productive for this offense as he was with the Eagles.
Second and 10. Looking across the middle. Wilson's tackled down after a gain of 5. As we look at this defensive lineup, linebacker John Beeson is a big-time leader for this unit.
Anytime you get a middle linebacker who has really good talent and leadership skills, you've got a guy that you want to call your middle linebacker and the quarterback of your defense.
Sherman's met at the 30.
Smith's job is to sell that play fake, and boy, did he do it that time. It fooled the defense, and they get the completion.
The Chiefs will take the snap from the 30. Had it, but dropped it.
Well, he dropped the football. There's no doubt why he dropped it. You have to look it in.
Second down over, coming up. Charles is going to take the handoff now.
Charles is trying to be patient, but there is nowhere to run that time, and he only gets a short gain.
It'll be third down. The Chiefs come to the line. First down marker at the 40. Smith's going to take the snap from the shotgun. The Chiefs now move the chains, and now they'll be on the other side of the 50 after this play.
When you run the slant route, it's very important to know as a receiver that you're going to catch that football probably in between some linebackers.
Let's see what they do on first down following that huge play. Alex Smith from the gun. He'll throw it over the middle. Maclin's brought down after picking up 6 on this play.
That time the quarterback throws the drag route. It doesn't get a first down, but still it's a good decision by him. The throw was right on target, and it picked up solid yards.
Second down, 3 for the first. Avant makes the catch. He's tackled beyond the markers. It's a first down.
That's a good job by the receiver running the drag route across the field. These are not easy throws for the quarterback, but he sticks it right on him for the completion.
First and 10, Jamal Charles. Collins is there that time for the tackle.
Charles is a dangerous runner when you give him room to run, but there is no room this time. What a job by the defense. They bottle him up for a short game.
Set up now at the 26. And the second quarter is underway with this snap. A game breaker. Touchdown. Just underway here in the second, and it looks like they're going to stay aggressive in this quarter if that touchdown is any indication.
Hard to believe it. Here we are early in the second, and we already got a lead that just got increased. I give the offense credit, but somewhere along the line, the defense of the opponents has to step up and just be tougher.
No return. The ball's coming out to the 20. The Giants just gave up some big turnover points. Let's see if they can hold on to the football this time, Phil, because we know how crucial it is. We talked to the coaches about it this week. This was their concern with this team.
Well, if you want to stay on the field, you better quit turning it over, right, Jim? That's what the coaches, look, you make mistakes on the field, they're going to be forgiving to a point, but you got to be smart, you got to be efficient, and get the job done.
Quick drop back. Smith nearly comes away with the pick on that pass.
Well, when there's man-to-man coverage on the defensive side, and the defense does a job like this where they are covering those receivers, there is nothing a quarterback can do except that throw another incomplete pass.
For this play, they'll go with 2 tight ends. They'll go ground. That's a gain of 6.
Nice run that time. When you run the football like this, over a period of time, it's going to wear that defense out. There's no doubt about it. Nice job by the offensive line.
Third down now. Vereen lined up in the backfield. And he's going to be sacked. So, just three plays and out for the offense. The Giants elect to go for it and bypass the punt on fourth down. Eli Manning will take it from the center here. The Giants turned the ball over on downs.
Good job by the defense that time.
looking like I'm gonna get it. You probably don't get it. I come in your house with a microphone looking like I'm about to set up a show in your kitchen. I'm out of my mind, but I feel like I'm in it. If I never make it, don't make any difference. I'm still gonna kill it. You know what the deal is. I never know telling when I'm in the building. And F is a monster. I am a villain. My music is sick and you don't know what ill is. You better get back. I don't write any filler. I write what I feel and I'm feeling a million. So you better shh. Be quiet. You hear it? I'm about to lose it. I'm on a whole different level of music. Don't treat me like I have no clue how to do this. You better rethink what you're thinking and move. Now picture me writing when I was a kid trying to make it in music. I think it is crazy. I spend all my money on studio time trying to get on my music so people could play it. Keep it 100, my music was terrible. Learn to get better than one that I made. Go back to my moment's album. Most of you people, you probably don't know what I'm saying. Hold up! What you witnessing now? Don't try to figure me out. I grab on that microphone, jump in that crowd. They was laughing at me. Who they laughing at now, huh? I laugh at myself. Some people, they looking like wow. The moment you told me that you was a rapper, I couldn't believe it. You believe it now? Step in the booth and I'm murdering. You never heard of a rapper that killer like I do. I sleep on the couch in the studio. Stay up till 3 in the morning and write till I gamble. The moment I wake up, I feel like I don't even sleep and I'm ready to put on my record. Well, thank you for buying it. Maybe you burned it. But either way, I'm gonna wreck it. I look at the industry, look what it did to me. You'll never make it if you never grind. You put a whole lot of money into it. You better be ready to give it your time. I look at the past several years of my life and I promise you I've been giving it mine. Try to keep up with this. I'm not a puppet. No string on my back. I'm one of a kind. Music is changing. No way to tame this. I am an artist. Look what I painted. Hang up the caution tape. I'm dangerous. Does anyone know where my brain is? Rappers are comfortable knowing they're famous, but I really don't care what your name is, and I really don't care if I'm nameless. Y'all just drive it.
And gave me a shot, and look at it now. I look at the team I'm dealing with. Ah, these people ain't playing around. Looking back, I got a lap. I was in a whole different place a year ago. I look at the map, and thank you God, I swear it's a miracle. And I'm sorry, but I gotta leave. My man, this track was beautiful. The least I can do if I murder a beat is take the time to go to his funeral.
Chiefs, Colts on EA Sports. We welcome you to Indianapolis, Indiana for today's game.
When you look at this matchup, you've got to talk about the deep threats, the guys that can go long, and two of the best, speediest receivers in the game are going to be on the same field today.
Yeah, it's going to be fun to see how they, both teams, the offenses, how do they get the football to these speedy wide receivers. And no matter what you do on the defensive side, you go, well, we're going to take them out of the game, we're going to double team them. Really, how are you going to do that when they're in motion? They're always changing formations. Very tough to do now. You just got to rely on good tackling and try to prevent those short catches and long runs.
The Colts come out with a split backfield. Luck's going to take it from the gun. Johnson with the grab. Picks up about two. Let's set the lineup for this offense. He has turned himself into a star wideout in this league out of Florida International, T.Y. Hilton.
There are a lot of teams around the NFL look at T.Y. Hilton and they go, why did we not draft him
before he went in the third round. And you know what I say to those teams? I don't know why you didn't draft him. He is an excellent wide receiver.
On the way, third down. Luck set in the pistol. Pass is intercepted. Tackle's made. And that pick could be an early momentum swing.
Man, when you're a quarterback and you throw an interception early, sometimes that's hard to overcome. You got to talk to yourself and just try to stay aggressive.
First down at the 49. Charles inside. Kansas City in the offseason went out and picked up wide receiver Jeremy Maclin from the Eagles, and he's quite a dynamic player, Phil.
Yeah, Jim, and they needed him in Kansas City. Wide receivers caught no touchdowns last year for this football team. They need somebody outside who can make some plays.
Second and nine. Jason Avant on the receiving end. Mathis in on the tackle.
Well, the drag route that time picked up solid yards. These receivers, sometimes they get a little nervous running these drag routes or these short crossers because they are afraid a defender's going to come out of nowhere and hit them. That's the quarterback's job. See in front of the receiver, lead the guy to the open space.
He's brought down. That's going to bring up fourth down.
Charles is looking for a place to run, but there is nowhere to go. The offensive line just gets dominated. Good job by the defensive line that time.
Touchback now as the ball comes out to the 20. Quarters formation here for the defense. First down at the 20. Gore's tackled down at the 24. Let's showcase this defense. And one of the top tacklers in the game today is linebacker Derek Johnson.
Derek Johnson, Jim, he has been doing it for a long time. He's crafty, man. He knows how to get around people. He plays middle linebacker. He gives out punishment but takes very little himself. That's what you have to do as a defensive back. You got to wait to the last second. Wait till the receiver uses his hands. And once they go up, put your hand in between them and knock that football down. What a play.
The Colts have it at the 24. Ball's incomplete. Fourth down coming up. Looks like they'll go three and out on this series. They're going to go for it here on fourth and six. The Colts are at the line of scrimmage with a pair of backs split behind the quarterback. The Colts turned the ball over on downs.
The Colts decided to go for it on fourth down that time, and hey, it didn't pay off. And, of course, the coach, look at him now. He is second-guessing his decision.
The Chiefs' offense is on the field, hoping to erase the memory of their last drive, which was completely unproductive, a quick three and out.
Yeah, it was. I don't know if they can erase this defense. This defense is pretty good. We saw that in the last drive. They got good players, and they're pretty excited. So this is going to be tough on the offense.
Let's set the lineup for this defense. The former Cleveland Brown linebacker is DeQuell Jackson.
Yes, Jim, when you talk about DeQuell Jackson, just one of those inside linebackers. He's fast, he's physical. He is a great fit for this defense.
The Colts with a nickel look here on defense. Smith takes it from the gun, throws the pass. It's complete to Jeremy Maclin, and he's tackled down after picking up the first. How about the way he always locks in and concentrates on the catch?
Man, he's got hands like glue. When you shake his hand, he can break yours because that's how strong they are. So not surprised to see him just reach out and just snatch the football out of the air.
And it's DeQuell Jackson who makes the tackle.
Charles is never able to build up that power that he has as a running back when there's nowhere to go.
Hey, there's nowhere to go. That's a short game.
Two tight ends on the field here. Second down and nine. And they'll give it to Jamal Charles. Slashes to the left side. Charles takes the hit and is brought down. That's going to be a pickup of three. Breaking huddle at the 8-yard line. Smith's back in shotgun formation. It's intercepted. And he's brought to the ground. We're back here getting ready for the second quarter. Phil, that was a defensive tug of war the first quarter.
It sure was, and it was a tug of war, and it was boring. That's what it looked like. I want to give the defense some credit. I thought they did well, but really the offenses just poor play selection, poor execution, and you got to get some emotion going out there on the offensive side.
Cleaners brought down after picking up only a yard. And here we have second down. The Colts line up, split backfield. Luck's got it in the gun. Hilton's there to catch the ball that had a lot of heat on it. Almost to the 40 at the 39-yard line. Here's the first snap after the big play from the shotgun. That's dropped by Andre Johnson, who couldn't bring it in.
Well, the quarterback that time tried to squeeze it into tight coverage, but no can do. The coverage is too good, and the football falls incomplete.
Luck standing back in the shotgun, ready for the snap. Moncrief's got it on a pass that had some heat. Smith there to make the tackle.
What a nice throw and catch that time, but here it just shows you why you want to have a lot of speed on the defensive side. So when you make a mistake, what do? You make up for it by chasing the player down from behind and making the tackle.
The Colts have it at the 34. Luck gets it to Kobe Fleener. Just 25 yards to pay dirt. Second and short. Four. And he's tackled, but not until he picked up the first down.
If you're running back and you want more carries, do things like this. Read the defense right, read the blocking, and pick up first downs. That's a really good job by the running back.
The Colts take it from the 23. Buries all over that offense and brings him down. The line of scrimmage right at the 24. Gore is in the backfield. Second down and 10. Luck throwing it long. And incomplete. Didn't get his feet down.
Sometimes on third and long from the defensive side, I like the fact that you can blitz. Send more guys than they can block. Make the quarterback throw the football quickly and short. Then it's all up to coming up and making the tackle.
The Colts take it from the 23. And it's complete to Dwayne Allen. This will be a field goal try for Vinatieri. Trip for the offense. And now we reach the 2-minute warning here in the second quarter. The Chiefs walk to the line. Tie game. The score 0-0.
Under, under, under. Four, four.
The Chiefs have it at the 29. Charles inside. And Lowry's there to make the stop.
When you run the football like this and you show toughness, there is no doubt when you fake it and try to throw the football down the field, the quarterback's going to have all day to get it done.
Jamal Charles is in the backfield. The Chiefs from the 37 to the ground. He's tackled beyond the markers. It's a first down. He's averaged about 2 yards a carry on the day. First down, offense readying for the snap.
They're changing things here. The quarterback changing. He's giving the receiver some new instructions.
Going deep. Almost intercepted.
I think that's the hardest pass a defensive back has to defend. The long throws down the field. You have to wait till the last second to make your play. That time the defensive back did it. What a play.
Alex Smith will take it right from the center. Second and 10. Both, the ball is fumbled. That brings the play to an end.
It's plain and simple. If you want to stay in the game, you got to hold on to the football. That time, that fumble, that was careless. Keep those hands wrapped around it when the defenders are getting ready to hit you.
This series begins for the offense with a very good chance to score. The Chiefs with two extra defensive backs in the dime. First down at the 40. Complete over to Dante Moncrief. The pass play picks up only 2. So now it's second down and 8 following the completion. Defender tips it out.
That's a wonderful job that time by the secondary. Everybody's in position, nowhere for the quarterback to throw the football, and it leads to another incomplete pass.
They face 3rd and 8 after failing to connect on that last pass play. And he's going to be dropped for the sack, and they're going to be punting after a short series. No surprise, it's another 3rd down stop, and this has been a first half where both of these defenses have had the upper hand, Phil.
Yeah, it's been physical, it's been fast, and it's been good. Now I'm talking about the defenses. On the offense, the best thing they've done is not make a major mistake to put their team in a hole, so the second half is going to be interesting to watch.
The Colts don't want any part of punting the football. They're going to go for it on 4th down. The Chiefs call a timeout, their first. Going for it on 4th down. Andrew Luck in shotgun formation. The Colts turn the ball over on downs. The Colts go for it on 4th and long, and it does not work out.
Well, listen, 4th and long, no matter when you go for it, your chances of making it are not very good. And that time, it doesn't work. Good job by the defense being alert and knowing the situation.
First down at the 46. And now here's Charles on the toss. He's averaged about 2 yards a carry on the day.
Charles is trying to be patient, but there is nowhere to run that time, and he only gets a short gain.
It's now 2nd down and 7 after the 3-yard rush.
Look out, they're changing the play to take advantage of something they see on the defensive side.
But it's incomplete.
Well, there's no doubt about it. This guy has a strong arm. That time, he just sails the football way past the receiver deep down the field.
It's third down coming up.
Three-step drop. Looking at every option. The ball is taken out of his hands. We'll switch sides and take a break for halftime as the second quarter has come to a close here in Circle City. Back to Indianapolis after a short break. The Chiefs are anxious to return the kickoff. We're underway in the second half now. Which team will be able to open up a lead here? Davis is going to test the coverage here. And he's out across the 20 and tackled at the 21. The Chiefs come out onto the field, now looking to get something positive going here to take the lead in this game, Phil, as we start the second half.
Yeah, they would like to do that. Of course, you always want to take the lead, but when you get into the second half and you get on top, man, that starts to put the pressure on the other team. So that's their thinking. I think they will come out here and be very aggressive to start the second half.
They're going to the hurry. Back to the line now. Alex Smith's going to take it from the shotgun. And there's a drop.
These receivers in the NFL, they are so good now. Anytime you see a drop pass, it's almost always the one reason. They took their eyes off the football before it got there.
The incompletion stopped the clock, but third and eight still to come. The Colts will come out in the dime. Heat on it. It's first down as they head to the line. Smith will have it in the pistol. And they'll run the football with Charles. That's a gain of only a yard. He's averaged about 2 yards a carry on the day. That last running play was good for only a yard, so it's second down and 9.
That was excellent man-to-man coverage at time. When you want to shut down a receiver, really the only way to do it is to man up and play him one-on-one.
After the incomplete pass, it's third down. The Chiefs need to get to the 50 for a first down. Alex Smith from the gun. Looking long. Complete. Defense was the order of the first half, Phil Simms, and it's hard to even see a scenario where that doesn't continue.
I think we got a trend going here. Here we are in the third quarter, and the offenses are still locked up, can't do anything. I don't care. I like this. Defenses rule today.
Bray's going to look for space now. That's a gain of 8. The Colts offense comes onto the field after a tie ball game through 2 quarters, Phil.
Usually in the second half, offenses kind of get the advantage. Why? Because the defense starts to tire out a little, and you can spring different plays on them because you've learned what they like to do. Can they come out here and take advantage of this defense? I think they're going to have a good drive right here.
And it's incomplete.
Sometimes when you have a player with this kind of talent, you're willing to put up with a few drop passes because when he catches it, he has a chance of going all the way.
Second down and 10. Luck finds Hilton. They come to the line of scrimmage. First down. Luck's alone in the backfield. He'll take the snap from the gun. Luck finds Fleener. Going to take it the distance. The 10, and he's in for the touchdown. What a play. What a run.
Tight ends are becoming a bigger and bigger part of the passing offense in the NFL. It leads to a touchdown this time. Nice job by the big guy just getting in position to make the catch.
And the point after is good. The Chiefs are anxious to return the kickoff. And Davis is running this one out. Just across the 20 and tackled at the 21. The Chiefs bringing their offense onto the field. It wasn't a very productive possession for them last time out, partner. They ended up punting.
Well, you know what it was? It was a good feeling out process. So they got some knowledge by watching the defense and what defenses they tried on them. So you've got to take advantage of that knowledge and come out here and make some plays.
Stands in the pocket. And it's batted down.
What a good job by the offensive line. They gave the quarterback all day to throw it. He just couldn't put it on target.
After the incomplete pass, it brings up second down. The Colts go with the dime formation here on defense. Smith takes it from the gun. Comes away with it.
The Chiefs look pretty confident out there on the field, don't they? And they're very calm, and they should be. That first down, they're right in this game. Don't look down the field for that big play. Just keep marching.
Double tight end formation. First down at the 35. Got a big lane.
Charles is a great running back to have on your football team, isn't he? He goes up in there and gets the first down. Now your offense has three more chances.
They're able to move the chains after that last run. Here they come back to the line after picking up over 20 yards on that last play. Charles, left side, for about four.
Charles is a dangerous runner when you give him room to run, but there is no room this time. What a job by the defense. They bottle him up for a short gain.
The football sits at the 42-yard line. Second and six. And he'll hand it off to the fullback. Freeman, that time on the tackle.
Always good to have these types of runs. Yeah, it's not a first down, but it sends a message. It shows everybody that you can run it when you want to. And also, it opens up so many other things for your offense.
Now, looking at third down. Smith's going to be in the pistol here. Smith's got two tight ends on the field for this snap. Down the field. The Chiefs will use a timeout here early in the second half. The offense back out on the field here for this fourth and short play. Charles, the lone setback this time. The Chiefs snap it at the 36. Up in the air and comes down with the catch.
The Chiefs, good job that time moving the chains, picking up that first down. And, Jim, of course, there's no time to panic in a situation like this. I think they know that. It's in the second half. You're down just a few points. Just keep looking for ways to get another first down, and that'll serve your team well.
Jackson's all over the ball carrier. Smith's completion percentage, 40% on the day. It's been all about the defenses today as we welcome you back to the action. Coming to the line at the 18. Smith lining up in the pistol.
The final quarter begins with this snap. And it's knocked down.
Gets tight down here in the red zone. So if you're a defender, read the quarterback. If you make a quick break on the football, hey, you get in position like this, you can knock it down.
They break huddle at the 18-yard line.
Plenty of defensive backs out on the field for this one.
Smith's going to take the snap from the shotgun. And intercepted.
He's brought down. Another outstanding defensive play. They've given that offense fits for over three quarters.
Oh, man, listen, if this is a fight, Jim, they would have called it off a long time ago. The offense, they're out on their feet. They're just standing up. They can't do anything.
Luck, handoff. Gains five. He's averaged about 2 yards a carry on the day.
Nice run that time. When you run the football like this, over a period of time, it's going to wear that defense out. There's no doubt about it. Nice job by the offensive line.
Second down after going to the ground game the first play. Second down, four to go.
Justin Houston with the sack.
It is truly a bonus when you can take your outside linebacker and let him rush the quarterback and he can get a sack. Nice job that time by the outside linebacker.
An extra tight end on the field for this one.
Intercepted.
Still, it might have been the only way they were going to score today. Return that interception for a touchdown in the fourth quarter.
Well, let's have a little more faith in that, Jim. Let's believe in this offense. I know they do. We talked to them during the week. They thought they were going to come out here and play really well today. That means they had to have some good thoughts. Well, think about those. Go out there and see if you can execute the plays.
Intercepted.
Much time left here, and this defense can feel it and smell it. A shutout is within reach.
Yeah, you can see the excitement on the sidelines. That's what they want. That's what this game is all about right now, keeping that shutout.
They come to the line, and it's first down.
Toss play here to Gore. Smith there to make the tackle.
Second and 10.
And the give to Frank Gore. And that's Poe in on the stop.
Good job that time by the defense. They're down. It's in the fourth quarter. They are expecting the offense to run the football, and they stop it for a couple yards.
Lux ready for the snap. Empty backfield. They'll hike it to him out of the shotgun.
Well, the game is close. You're losing. It's third down. You need to get a stop, and the defense does it. Now it's fourth down, and they give the football back to their offense.
Thomas got it now. That's a gain of 10.
The Chiefs have to still be thinking about that last possession. They were actually moving down the field. And then, of course, the untimely interception ended things.
Yeah, the defense, look, they got good players. And, you know, you give them enough chances, they're finally going to make the play. You have to be careful with the football. The offense was not, and that's why it resulted in an interception.
What do you think they're talking about in that huddle after that drive-killing interception?
They're probably telling the quarterback, if you do that again, we're going to kick you out. I don't know, but they got to play better.
Time, and this one's running out, and the defense knows it needs another stop.
Looking to go down the field here. He rips it right out of the wide receiver's hands.
Got to give this secondary credit. In this passing league now, it's hard to make plays, but a good play there and another incomplete pass.
Time is beginning to fade, but the quarterback knows his team still has a chance. He must produce something in a hurry.
Pass is intercepted.
Phil, this offense is completely stumped by the defense as they give the ball away again.
All day long, it looked like right from the first quarter all the way through the end, they never had a chance, and that's exactly what happened. The defense dominated them on every level of play. Just a great performance by the defense here today.
Andre Johnson has the catch. Following that completion, second and short.
If they're going to have any chance at all here late in the fourth, the defense must make a big stop and give the ball back to the offense.
2 minutes to go in the second half. The Chiefs defense now loading up, expecting pass. Derek Johnson rushing in and takes him down.
What a good scheme that time by the defense. They confuse the offense. They blitz. They don't know who to pick up. And how about the defender? They must love this. Coming in free and gets a good clean shot on the QB and gets a sack.
The Colts have it at the 39. And it's swatted away.
When you're in a situation like this, and it's third and real long, don't take a chance. Be careful and get off the field.
Failing to connect there, third down.
Luck out of the gun. Trying to find his target over the middle, but that pass goes incomplete. The Colts, one timeout remaining.
The coach is going to go for it.
They'll go for it on fourth down, late stages. Leaps in the air and has it.
Well, when you're winning in a tight game in the second half, I don't know about going for it on fourth down. That was a big decision. It could come back to really haunt them.
The Chiefs offense takes the field, and they are absolutely in desperate need of a big-time drive here to put points on the board.
The one thing we do know, since you are behind, the defense most likely is going to be very...
A foot race to the end zone. All the way home and all alone. Touchdown.
That's a nice touchdown here. You're still losing, but you know what you've done? You've put the game in doubt. So don't give up. Keep your confidence up. The other team, they're getting tight. Make them get tighter. You still have a chance to get this done.
Bray's got a chance to return this one. Fights through that hit, and he's on the sidelines and out of bounds.
That return's good for about 31.
The Colts offense takes the field here, looking for some late game magic here, partner, with the game tied late.
Yeah, you're looking for magic, but also be careful. The one thing I like about the NFL now, all the teams have so many plays to start the drive. And what I mean by that, it's just not a screen or a draw. They have all these wide receiver screens. You throw it outside. I don't want to call them trick plays, but deceptive plays that make it easy for you.
Inside, and he's caught for the touchdown. Yards on that scoring drive gave them the boost they had to have to get the critical score.
Wide receivers like him, Jim, you just can't deny it. They have so much talent, it's hard to hold them down all the time, and he came through in a couple spots in that drive.
It's good. The Colts getting set for the kickoff. Davis going to start his return. And the tackle is made right around the 26-yard line. The Chiefs offense comes out here, Phil, desperately looking to put a drive together that can give them a chance here late to win this game.
Always the tough thing to do in a situation like this for the offense is don't try to make the big play. Let it happen. Take a short gain if that's what the defense is giving you, especially on first down. Get this drive started by doing the right thing.
Now on first down, every snap crucial the rest of the way. First down at the 41. Alex Smith looking long. Tries to get the feet down, but this will be ruled incomplete. So they're coming off an incompletion. They do have a timeout, so before there's another snap, the officials want to go back and take a look at that last one. There's no question he caught the ball, but there is a question whether or not he got both feet in bounds.
Well, first off, you want to make sure it's a clean catch on the sidelines. Does he have possession of the football? And then once you declare he has possession of the football, let's look down at both feet, see if they're in bounds, and don't forget, you must maintain possession of the football as you go to the ground.
And this is a crucial third down play coming up. The Colts signal for the timeout, and they have none remaining. This is a big third down snap. The Chiefs snap it at the 41. Has the reception all alone. Touchdown!
What a job by this team. They have fought hard all day long, and they find a way to get a touchdown. Now they're only an extra point from tying this game up. What a job.
Driving extra point is good. What a game this has been. Tied up now in the waning moments of the fourth.
Well, when it gets this late in the game, it just comes down to, do you have the courage to try to make the play, or you just hang in there and hope the other team makes a mistake? We'll find out.
And they stop him from running it out to the 20. Mark him down at the 19. The Colts come onto the field. The game now is in the hands of this offensive unit with the game tied, Phil.
Jim, this is a situation now where you just don't come out here and just try to make it happen. The game is tied, and if it doesn't work, you figure, well, let's try to get into overtime. So be careful on these first couple plays and make sure you don't make a big mistake.
Luck's going to take it from the gun. Airing it out. One-handed grab. Bill, that's one of the best one-handed catches we've seen all year, isn't it?
Jim, that's one of the best. You don't see many this outstanding in these wide receivers. If they can't get two hands on the football, they've taught themselves over time just to go up and stretch as far as they can and get that one hand on it, and it is amazing how many times they make the catch.
Ray's going to test the coverage this time. They're all over him at the 18-yard line. and Drew Luck under center. First down at the 18. Here's the handoff, and they'll run it. Second down and three following that nice run. The give. Going to lose yards here. Third down on the way. Luck will take the snap from the gun. And it's batted down.
What a job by the defender that time, reading the quarterback and the receiver and being in position to knock that football away. That is really well played. That's a clinic. Put that on the highlight film and show guys how to do it.
The offense is still on the field here on fourth down, needing six for the first. It's Luck out of the pistol. The Colts from the 22. The Colts turn the ball over on downs.
The Colts that time go for it on fourth down, and they fail. I did not understand the decision, but you got to make sure your team doesn't get down from that. You got to keep them up.
Charles lined up in the backfield. First down at the 22. Nowhere to go, as this will be a loss of three.
The Chiefs running back that time, he makes a bad decision. You can't be looking to make every play a big play when you're running the football. Look for a few yards, take advantage of that. He tries for the big play. What happens? He gets tackled for a loss.
Loss of three on the play. Second down and 13. Avant makes the catch. Butler's the one who brings him to the ground.
You got to be agile when you make these kind of catches, running these short drag routes across the field. That time we saw the agility of the receiver. Nice catch.
Smith's completion percentage, 40% on the day. Smith's back in shotgun formation. And it's knocked down.
Things get tight down here in the red area. I got to give the defensive man a lot of credit, though. In position, sees the ball thrown, and is able to get that hand up there and knock it down.
Drives it through for the field goal.
You got to take advantage of good field position. The offense doesn't do it that time. I know they get 3 points out of it. Nice kick, but still a letdown for the offense.
It was memorable. It was overtime, and it was won with a field goal.
Yeah, what a tough spot for a field goal kicker to come in, win or lose the game on the fact that he has to make a kick like that. Came through in the clutch, and he got it done.
For Phil Simms and all the crew at EA Sports, Jim Nance saying so long for now.